Well, some of the senior officials across the defence services have arrived at Kateri, the place that you see right behind me. Now, this is the terrain that you're looking at, the crash site that we are at this particular point in time. Now, what's important to note that is that including the Air Chief, we are Chowdhury and various other senior officials as well have arrived at the spot. They are picking up clues in terms of some of the crucial evidence to understand what really went wrong, especially when the chopper was on its way to the DSSC college. Now, it's also important to remember that General Bipin Rawat, in fact, he along with the, in fact, 13 other persons, some of the senior officials, they had taken off from the Sulur Air Base and they were heading towards the DSSC college, which is at Wellington. They were just into a few kilometers away, we understand, just about 7 to 8 kilometers before landing at the Defence Services Staff College. But it was at that particular point in time, right up here in this terrain region, where we understand the crash had taken place. Now, to give you a broader perspective of this particular hilly region, the topography, if I could show you, now the Kunur, the municipality town, is nestled in the Nilgiris hilly region, mountainous hilly region. Of course, there are rolling slopes that we're looking at, and at a high altitude also we're looking at over 6,000 feet. So this is the kind of topography, and it's the high terrain where exactly the crash had taken place. But remember, it is clearly a very premature stage to talk about what really went wrong during those last moments. In fact, it is only for some of the senior officials to say this, because at the spot the investigation is still on. Some of the most important crucial evidences, materials are being collected that will then be sent for investigation. Also, they're trying to retrieve the black box to understand what really happened in those final moments, to understand the crash where the chopper was crashed at this very particular spot. Remember, it took away nearly 13 people's lives, and there is only one lone survivor who's now continuing to undergo treatment at the Wellington Military Hospital. With camera person Kumar, this is Sridhar reporting for NDTV in Kateri.